فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So that statement of Imam Yunus ibn Ubayd rahimahullah, Imam al-Mizzi rahimahullah, he brought in his kitab Tahdhib al-Kamal, Abu Nu'aym in his kitab Hilyat al-Awliya wa Tabaqat al-Asfiya, and also al-Lalaka'i Abu Qasim Hibatullahi al-Lalaka'i rahimahullah, he brought it in his kitab Usul I'tiqad Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And the chain is authentic, as was classified and authenticated by Imam al-Dhahabi in his seerah. فضيلة الشيخ العلامة الشيخ صالح بن فوزان الفوزان حفظه الله in his شرح of كتاب شرح السنة by إمام البربهاري رحمه الله الشيخ صالح الفوزان said صارت السنة غريبة غريبا من يدعو إليها وأقرب منه من يعمل بها فلا شك أنه يأتي أزمان تكون السنة غريبة في أهلها وكلما تأخر الزمان صارت السنة غربة وأهل السنة غرباء هؤلاء هم الغرباء في آخر الزمان إذا فسد الناس فهم يتمسكون بالسنة ويصبرون على ما نالهم من الأذى ويصبرون على الغربة بين الناس لأن الذين يخالفونهم كثيرون فهم يعيشون في غربة بين الناس. الشيخ صالح الفوزان رحمه حفظه الله تعالى حفظه الله he says page 463 in his sharh of kitab sharh sunnah he says the sunnah has become strange the sunnah has become gharib and the one who calls to it has also become gharib strange and what has become even more strange is the one who implements the sunnah and then the sheikh goes on to say in fala shakka annahu yati azmanun and without a doubt there's going to come times as-sunnah gharibatan fi ahliha that the sunnah is going to be strange amongst its people wa kullama ta'akhkhara az-zaman and every time adds on and it gets closer to the hour sarat as-sunnah ghariban sarat as-sunnah gharibatan the sunnah will become strange wa ahli as-sunnah ghuraba And the people of the Sunnah are غرباء. Until he said, هَؤُلَاءِ هُمُ الْغُرَبَاءِ فِي آخِرِ الزَّمَانِ And they are the strangers in the last, before the hour. إِذَا فَسَدَ النَّاسِ When the people become corrupt, فَهُمْ يَتَمَسَّكُونَ بِالسُنَّةِ They are holding on to the Sunnah. وَيَصْبِرُونَ عَلَى مَا نَالَهُمْ مِنَ الْأَذَى And they are patient upon the harm that they are afflicted with. وَيَصْبِرُونَ عَلَى الْغُرْبَةِ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ And they are also patient upon being strangers whilst they're with the people. لِأَنَّ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَهُمْ Because those who oppose them are a lot in number. كَثِيرُونَ فَهُمْ يَعِيشُونَ فِي غُرْبَةٍ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ And they are living as strangers amongst the people. So without a doubt today, the person who wants to call to the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم فَهُوَ غَرِيبٌ فهو غريب بين الجهال. That person becomes a stranger amongst the people. And as I said before, he becomes a stranger amongst his own people that he's from. So I say, my beloved brothers and sisters, فيا أهل السنة أو أهل السنة إلزموا السنة, hold on to the sunnah. وتمسكوا بها and hold on to it. Stick by it. Remain with the sunnah. فإنكم غرباء. For verily you guys are strangers بين الناس amongst the people. You guys are strangers amongst the people. So hold on to the sunnah even more at this particular time. Al-Imam Abi Bakr ibn Ayyash rahimahullah. This statement is narrated by Al-Imam Al-Harawi in his kitab Dhamm al-Kalam. Khatib al-Baghdadi in his kitab Al-Jami' li-Akhlaq al-Rawi wa Adab al-Sami' Al-Lalaka'iyu in his kitab Usul I'tiqad Ahli Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Ibn al-Jawzi in his kitab Talbisu Iblis. All of them, they narrated it min turuq Abi Bakr ibn Ayyash. And the sanad is authentic without a doubt. That Abi Bakr ibn Ayyash rahimahullah, he said, أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ مِثْلُ الْإِسْلَامِ فِي سَئِرِ الْأَدْيَانِ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ are in Islam like Islam is in comparison to other religions. أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ within Islam, they are like the way Islam is in comparison to other religions. Now that I've mentioned those points, I want to, inshaAllah ta'ala, read some quotes of the A'immatu Salaf, the pious predecessors. Statements of them and statements of theirs, in which they tell us and they direct a advice at us. InshaAllah ta'ala, may Allah make us from the people of the Sunnah. Ameen. That they are requesting from us and advising us that we don't find loneliness. And we don't feel lonely if we're upon the haqq. Even if we have little who are with us on that haqq. Al-Imam al-Bayhaqi in his kitab Az-Zuhd al-Kabir, min tariqi, from the narration of Al-Husayn ibn al-Hassan ibn Ayyub, who said, Anba'ana Abu Hatim al-Raziyu, haddathana Abu Abdillahi al-Najjar, who is a thiqatun thabt, who said, qala Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah, that Sufyan ibn Uyayna said, and this, my brothers, sanaduhu sahih, the chain of narration is authentic, because some scholars, they do question the integrity of Abu Abdillah al-Najjar. They do. But no worries. He has a mutaba'a from Bishrun, who said, I heard Sufyan ibn Uyayna said this. And that one, Bayhaqi narrates it, that mutaba'a from Bishr. Bayhaqi narrates it in his kitab Az-Zuhd al-Kabir, min tariqi, from the chain of what? Ibn Samak, who narrated from Al-Hasan ibn Amr, who said, I heard Bishr say that Sufyan ibn Uyayna said. Also, there's another mutaba'a that supports Abu Abdullah al-Najjar al-Bishr, is Ishaq ibn Abi Israfil. Ishaq ibn Abi Israfil, who also said, I heard Sufyan ibn Uyayna say. So then all those are mutaba'at that strengthen. And of course, Abu Abdullah, the qawl al-rajih is that he is a thiqatun thabt. Sufyan ibn Uyayna, my beloved brothers and sisters, he said, إِلْزَمِ الْحَقَّ وَلَا تَسْتَوْحِشْ لِقِلَّةِ أَهْلِهِ. Stick to the truth. And do not feel lonely because of the little that are with you. And he also said in another wording, أُسْلُكْ طَرِيقَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا تَسْتَوْحِشْ مِنْهُ وَإِنْ كَانَ أَهْلُهُ قَلِيلًا. And the riwayah of Ishaq ibn Israfil, he said, إِسْلُكُوا سُبُلَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا تَسْتَوْحِشْ مِنْ قِلَّةِ أَهْلِهَا. Which all mean the same meaning. الشيخ صالح الفوزان حفظه الله, in his kitab اللَّمْحَةٍ عَنِ الْفِرَقِ, page 22, he says, وَلَيْسَتِ الْعِبْرَةُ بِالْكَثْرَةِ. Allahu Akbar. وَلَيْسَتِ الْعِبْرَةُ بِالْكَثْرَةِ. The real matter is not number. The reality of a matter is not number. It is not about number. بَلِ الْعِبْرَةُ بِالْمُوَافَقَةِ لِلْحَقِّ. But the reality of a matter is what is in accordance to the truth. وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ عَلَيْهِ إِلَّا قِلَّةٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Even if little are on that path, the issue isn't number. The issue is what is the truth. حَتَّى وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِي بَعْضِ الْأَزْمَانِ إِلَّا وَاحِدٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ فَهُوَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ وَهُوَ الْجَمَاعَةِ. Even at some times, if one person is upon a matter, and that is the truth, then he is the jama'ah. فَلَا يَلْزَمْ مِنَ الْجَمَاعَةِ الْكَثْرَةِ. And to be jama'ah is not necessary to have a large number. بَلِ الْجَمَاعَةَ. Rather, the jama'ah is مَنْ وَافَقَ الْحَقِّ, the one who is in accordance to the truth. وَوَافَقَ الْكِتَابَ وَالسُّنَّةِ, and is in accordance to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَوْ كَانَ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِ قَلِيلٌ. Even if those who are on that path are little in number. Even if those who are on that path and that are on that are little in number. الإمام الفضيل بن عياض رحمه الله, أثر which is صحيح. البيهقي narrated in his kitab الزهد الكبير, من طريقي, from the chain of Muhammad ibn Abi Hamzata al-Maruzi, who narrated from Ahmad ibn Ayyub al-Mutawwi'i, who said, I heard Al-Husayn ibn Ziyad say, qala Fudayl ibn Iyad. And my brothers, this sanad is, sanaduhu sahih, it's authentic. Also Ibn Asakir in his kitab تبيين الكذب المفتري. He brings it from this chain of narration from Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, which Fudayl says, لا تستوحش طريق الهدى لقلة أهله ولا تغتر بكثرة الناس. Do not get put off and find loneliness from the straight path and the guidance because the little that are on it. And do not be deceived by the large amount of people. Do not be put off from the path, the straight guided path, because of those who follow it are little in number. And do not be deceived by the large amount of people. So my beloved brothers, that statement of Fudayl ibn Iyad is telling us, my what? اتبع طرق الهدى. Follow the paths of guidance. ولا يضرك. Do not let it harm you. قلة السالكين. The little that tread on it. وإياك وطرق الضلالة. And be cautious and aware. And stay away from the paths which are misguidance. ولا تغتر بكثرة الهالكين. And do not be deceived by the large amount who are going to be punished by Allah anyways. Don't be deceived by that large amount. Also, Imam Fudayl ibn Iyad, he said, as Ibn Asakir brings in his kitab, Tariq al-Dimashq, from the chain of Abdul Jabbar ibn Ahmad al-Samarqandi, who said, I heard Muhammad ibn Ya'qub say, Muhammad ibn Ya'qub I'm speaking about is al-Farajiyu, rahimahullah, who said, I heard Abdul Samad ibn Yazid al-Mardawi say that I heard Fudayl ibn Iyad say, and this sanad is Hassan, طوبى لمن استوحش من الناس وكان الله أنسه. Prosperity be for the one who find loneliness from the people, but he accompanies himself with Allah. Why does he find loneliness from the people? Because he chose the truth over the large amount of people, and his companionship, he found it in who? He found it in Allah. Your issue is not the people. Your issue is, what does Allah tabarak wa ta'ala want? And how can I be in His, how can I be on what that which He desires and wants from me, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, in his kitab Madarij al-Salikin, the fourth volume, page 55, he said, قَالَ بَعْضُ السَّلَفِ, some of the pious predecessors said, and he's referring to specifically who? Fudayl ibn Iyad, because that's who we just quoted this statement from. He said, عليك بطريق الحق. Upon you is the straight path, the true path. ولا تستوحش لقلة السالكين وإياك وطريق الباطل ولا تغتر بكثرة الهالكين وكلما استوحشت في فردك وكلما استوحشت في تفردك فانظر إلى الرفيق السابق وَحْرِصْ عَلَى اللِّحَاقِ بِهِمْ وَغُضَّ الطَّرْفَ عَمَّنْ سِوَاهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَمْ يُغْنُوا عَنْكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا وَإِذَا صَاحُوكَ بِكَ فِي طَرِيقِ سَيْرِكَ فَلَا تَلْتَفِتْ إِلَيْهِمْ فَإِنَّكَ مَتَى الْتَفَتَّ إِلَيْهِمْ أَخَذُوكَ وَعَاقُوكَ. الإمام ابن القيم said that some of the Salaf, they said, referring to Fudayl ibn Iyad, that upon you is the straight and guided path. And do not be put off because of the little amount of people who are treading on that path. And stay away from that misguided path. And do not be deceived by the large amount who are going to be destroyed. And then he goes on to say, وَكُلَّمَا اسْتَوْحَشْتَ, and every time you feel loneliness, في تفرودك, in your loneliness, whenever you feel lonely in your loneliness, فانظر إلى الرفيق السابق, look at a righteous person who came before you, who went through this. Look at the friend that is in front of you who surpassed you. وحرص على اللحاق بهم, and strive to reaching him. وغض الطرف عن من سواهم, and turn a blind eye to those besides them, meaning besides the one that's in front of you. Just don't look at them. فإنهم لم يغنوا عنك من الله شيء, because they will not suffice you from Allah تبارك وتعالى. وإذا صاحوا بك, if they yell to you and they scream out to you, في طريق سيرك, or whilst you're on your path to Allah, and you're on that path to catching the one who's in front of you, if they call on to you the others, فلا تلتفت إليهم, don't look at them, don't even turn around. فإنك متى التفت إليهم, because when you look at them, أخذوك, they got you now, and they're gonna take you. وعاقوك, and they will deviate you from that path. الله أكبر, الله أكبر. Let alone listening to their whispers, and that which they have to say to you, don't even look at them. Set yourself that goal that you're heading towards, and a path that you have. And don't let them come and drag you off it. Don't let them come and drag you from it. My brothers and sisters, Salafu hadhi al-ummah, their advice regarding this is just excessive in number. Even if when they wrote letters to one another, they would remind each other of this. As Imam Ahmad ibn Bishr ibn Sulaiman al-Shaybani rahimahullah, he said, كَتَبَ رَجُّلٌ إِلَى رَجُّلٍ. This author, you can find it in Kitab al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, in his Kitab Tariq Baghdad. The sanad of it and the chain is what? مِنْ طَرِيقِ أَحْمَدِ ibn Ja'far ibn Salam al-Khutli. He said, حَدَّثَنَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ ibn Ahmad ibn Isa al-Fastamiyu. مَا الْفُسْطَامِيُ. حَدَّثَنِي عُمَرُ ibn Muhammad al-Nasa'iyu. He said, حَدَّثَنَ أَحْمَدُ ibn Bishr ibn Sulaiman al-Shaybani bihi. The sanad is Hassan, in which he said, a man wrote to another man, and he said to him, أما بعد, to proceed. هذا letter. It's a letter he's writing to him. He said to him, فليكن, let it be, أول عملك. This is straight after he said, أما بعد. He said, فليكن أول عملك الهداية بالطريق. Let the first action that you do be guidance to the straight path. ولا تستوحش لقلة أهله. And do not find loneliness. Do not be put off by the little who are on that straight path. فإن إبراهيم عليه السلام, because نبي الله إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله لا للملوك. Because Ibrahim was a nation, one who surrendered himself to Allah, not to the kings. فلا تستوحش مع الله. Do not find loneliness whilst you're with Allah. Do not be put off whilst you're with Allah. ولا تستأنس بغير الله. And do not find companionship in other than Allah تبارك وتعالى. Athar which is Hassan. Then their advices towards one another was this. Straight away he would say, فَلْيَكُونَ, let it be, أَوَّلَ عَمَلِكَ الْهِدَايَةُ بِالطَّرِيقِ. وَلِذَلِكَ الشيخ ناصر الدين الألباني, he once said to one of the students, he said, praise Allah تبارك وتعالى, and show gratitude to him. Be thankful that Allah, not only did he guide you to Islam, but he also guided you to the Sunnah. Guidance to the religion is good. But then to be guided upon the Sunnah and to be from the Ahlul Ghurbah is another thing that you need to come with gratitude towards. Shaykhul Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he said something very powerful in his Kitab Majmu' al-Fatawa, the fourth volume, page 450. He says, فَعَلَيْنَا أَن نُؤْمِنَ بِكُلِّ مَا جَاءَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Ibn Taymiyyah said, it is upon us to believe in everything that has come to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنُقِرُّ بِالْحَقِّ, and that we affirm the truth. وَلَا يَكُونُ لَنَا هَوًا وَلَا نَتَكَلَّمُ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ, and that it should not be for us a whims and desires. And there should not, we should not also speak without knowledge. بَلْ نَسْلُكُ سُبُلَ الْعِلْمِ, rather we tread on the path of knowledge. وَالْعَدْلِ, and the path of justice. وذلك هو اتباع الكتاب والسنة, and that path of knowledge and justice is what? It is following the Kitab and the Sunnah, he says. فأما من تمسك ببعض الحق دون بعض, anyone who holds on to some of the truth over the rest, فهذا منشأ الفرقة والاختلاف, this is the root cause of division and disputation. The khilaf that are occurring between the Muslims and the disputes that are occurring between the Muslims, if you really analyze it, my brothers, and you look at it, is what? Every party is holding on to a part of the religion, and the other one is holding on to the other part. Huh? So what is needed from us, brothers, is to be holding on to the religion wholeheartedly. وَلِذَلِكَ the Jews and the Christians, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say? وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ لَيْسَتِ النَّصَارَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَقَالَتِ النَّصَارَ لَيْسَتِ الْيَهُودُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَهُمْ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ. Each party is pointing the finger at the other party. It doesn't want to take from that party what it has, the truth that it has. Because he doesn't like that person, or he doesn't like that group, or he doesn't like that individual. And the other one, he does the same. And so he leaves the truth because of the individual he doesn't like. ولذلك Ibn Taymiyyah is telling you, this is what? This is منشأ الفرقة والاختلاف. This is why the ummah divide. And the disputations and the arguments come. لذلك, the person has to take the religion wholeheartedly. That's why Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah is saying to you, بَلْ نَسْلُكْ rather we take سُبُلَ الْعِلْمِ, the path of knowledge. وَالْعَدْلِ, and we're just. وَذَلِكَ هُوَ اتِّبَعُ الْكِتَابُ وَالسُنَّةِ, and that is by following the kitab and the sunnah. Pay attention. Allahu Akbar. Another statement that's going to come, which is the statement of Imam al-Awza'i, Imam Ahl al-Sham. Imam Ahl al-Sham bila mudafa'a, without any dispute. This author of him, this statement of his is sahih, is authentic. And Imam al-Bayhaqi narrated in his madkhal. Ibn Qudama in Dhamm al-Ta'wil, he brought it aliqan. Abu al-Fath al-Maqdisi, he brought it in Kitab al-Hujjah. Al-Ajurriyu, he brought it in Kitab al-Sharia. Khatib al-Baghdadi, he brought it in his Kitab Sharaf wa Ashab al-Hadith. Al-Harawi, he brought in his kitab Dhammul Kalam. Ibn Abdul Barr, he brings in his kitab Jami' Bayan al-Ilm wa Fadli. All of them, they brought it min turuqi an al-Abbas ibn al-Walid ibn min tariq al-Abbas ibn al-Walid ibn Mazyad, in which he said, akhbarani abi, my father told me that he heard al-Awza'i say. That al-Awza'i said. And Imam ibn Qudama also brings in his kitab Lum'at al-I'tiqad as well. That Imam al-Awza'i rahimahullah, he said, alayka bi athari man salaf. وإن رفضك الناس وإياك وآراء الرجال وإن زخرفوه لك بالقول فإن الأمر ينجلي وأنت منه على طريق مستقيم. And Imam al-Awza'i said, upon you is the textual evidence. عليك بآثار من سلف. Upon you is the path of the pious predecessors. It's still of their path. وإن رفضك الناس, even if the people refuse it from you. وإياك وآراء الرجال, stay away from the people's opinions, men's opinions. Stay away from that. Be cautious. Abstain from that. وَإِنْ زَخْرَفُوا لَكَ بِالْقَوْلِ, even if they beautify it with speech. Ah. فَإِنَّ الْأَمْرَ يَنْجَلِي, because the matter will become clear. وَأَنْتَ مِنْهُ عَلَى طَرِيقٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ, the matter will become clear to you and you are on the straight path, inshallah ta'ala. Just give it time. So here, Al-Imam Al-Awza'i is telling you what? Take the path of the pious predecessors. Because this is Ahlul Ghurba. This is what happens to the people who are strangers. All they have done is stayed away from the opinions of individuals. Because the opinions of individuals is what people try to beautify for you. A person will try to beautify his speech so much for you. When it's really absent from what? It is absent from any form of evidences. If you be patient upon that path of taking the textual evidences and taking that which the pious predecessors were upon, you will realize inshallah ta'ala later, when everything, as the scholars they say, إِذَنْ جَلَ الْغُبَارُ, when the dust goes down, you will realize what you're sitting on. Is it a donkey or is it a horse? You'll know. When everything goes down and the fitna and everything comes, you will realize what it is. Are you on the straight path or are you not? Inshallah ta'ala, it will become clear. Then stick with it. Also Imam al-Awza'i, he said another statement of his, which is sahih. Imam al-Asfahani, Abu Na'im al-Asfahani's kitab al-Hujjah fi bayan al-Mahajjah, he brings it. اللَّلَكَائِيُّ نِسُولُ اعْتِقَادِ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ, Abu Na'im al-Hilyat al-Awliya, طبقات الأسفية. عبد الغني, he brings in his الاقتصاد. ابن قدامة in ذم التأويل. And تعليقا من طريقين. But they bring it from two chains. One of it is being أبي إسحاق الفزاري. He said, I heard Awza'i say. إمام الأوزاعي said, إمام أهل الشام, اصبر نفسك على السنة وقف حيث وقف القوم وقل بما قالوا وكف عما كفوا عنه واسلك سبيل سلفك الصالح فإنه يسعك ما وسعهم. الإمام الأوزاعي said, be patient. I'ma make yourself patient upon the sunnah and stand where the previous nations, the pious predecessors, where they stood, and say that which they have said, and stay away from that which they stood away from, and take the path of those pious predecessors. فَإِنَّهُ يَسِعُكَ, because what suffices you is what suffices them. What has sufficed them is that which is going to suffice you.